All right. Hey, everybody. We are live. My name is James, and welcome to a Living for Crits actual play for Deadlands Reloaded. And with me tonight are some very special friends. So Andy Lyons here.
Hello.
How you doing, Andy?
I'm good. Ready to go.
Yeah. All right. Craig McCullough's here.
Howdy. Since we're being old westy.
Yeah, that's awesome. That's pretty old westy. Darcy Ross.
Darn tootin'. That's all I got. I've out wested myself.
Well, listen, so far it's gotten better since Andy and Craig started. So Mark Ford.
Yeah! Pressure's on now, Mark.
He just did it. Y'all missed it. Do it again, Mark.
Yeah.
Oh man. Beautiful. And Will Keller.
Y'all.
Just a bunch of y'alls. Oh man,
I believe that would be an all y'all.
It's all y'alls, yeah.
All y'alls.
All right. Well, thank you all for joining, and thank you all for playing. And just a quick recap: what we're doing here tonight. If you don't know, we have like a bunch of viewers already, which is awesome. It's crazy. Yay. Will just stood up and just gave us a little bit of a view with a NASA shirt. Nice. So we're playing Deadlands Reloaded tonight, and that is.
This book.
Well, and this book. For me, I mean, I think when it first came out for Reloaded, there was like one book. I have the two books. And that is a Savage World powered game. So here's the deluxe rule for Savage Worlds. And the reason we're playing this tonight and sort of it inspired me to get this rolling was that there are a pair of Kickstarters going on right now. And if you look in the show notes, and again, if you're watching this and it's like, you know, live, the Kickstarter is still going, but there is a Kickstarter for a Deadlands Classic 20th Anniversary book and one for Good Intentions, which is a Deadlands Reloaded, like sort of mega adventure, a mega plot point adventure. So both of those are happening simultaneously. So make sure you check those out. But saw that and kind of went into full Western, which meant I've been like watching all of Deadwood again. And I'm playing Red Dead Redemption, and my six-year-old's playing Red Dead Revolver, and it's so cute to watch him play that. So I know Pinnacle Entertainment Group has retweeted this a few times. So if you're watching this and you're a heavy Savage Worlds player, be warned. I play everything rules light. I'm crappy with rules. If it sounds awesome, we're just going to do it. We're going to do it like, you know, real loose and fast. So if you're like, well, that is not how it works in the game, you're probably right. It probably doesn't work that way. And I just have too many games I play to keep them all together. I do my best, though. Tonight is an interactive actual play. And what that means is you are going to be able to experience and play the game live with us, sort of, kind of. How that's going to work is if you are watching via the YouTube stream, which I think you should be doing probably, you can chat. There's like a chat box. And I'm watching it now. I'm watching myself talk, which is really creepy. You can chat things in there if you want into the game. You can also tweet at I Live for Crits. You can tweet, and I have my tablet out, so I'm going to try to take a look at this occasionally as well, just to make sure I see what's coming up. And the reason I say interactive is because if you think something crazy should happen in the game, either tweet it or message it, and I will try to throw it in. And if I torment one of the players, I will throw them a Benny. But you know what? We're not using Bennies tonight. We're using Fate Chips. So I've already broken the rules because Deadlands Reloaded uses Fate Chips instead of Bennies. We'll get into that later. So the other way it's interactive is that the adventure tonight, which is called The Unexpected Wedding of Blank, is sort of a Mad Lib style adventure, which means I did not fill in everything for the adventure. I instead left a bunch of blanks and players, not players, viewers or tweeters could send me info and I plugged it in. So this is a crazy random romp we're going to be experiencing tonight. And as I read through this, you're going to see how that goes. So I think before we kind of get this moving here any further, let's talk about the characters we have here. So from my left to right, so Andy, who are you playing? Andy? Craig, who are you playing?
I'm playing Lopan, who is a martial arts master with all kinds of chi powers.
Cool. Because Andy, when you come back on, Andy, you can tell us who you're playing. Oh, you're back, Andy. Look at that.
Sorry, can't pop him.
Who are you playing?
I'm playing Shady Doug Laveau. He's a huckster. He
nice.
Uses poker to magic stuff.
That's exactly how that works. Use poker to magic stuff. Yep. Okay, Darcy, who are you playing?
I'm playing Gracie Law, totally not stolen from some other high action flick. I'm playing the last time I played her, she was secretly a police agent who was masquerading as a journalist, and now she is an open agent, but she may or may not have a secret journalism gig on the side, so we will have to find out.
Cool.
Writes down.
Mark, who do you have?
I have Professor Cornelius Vandersmythe. He is he's a lot off kilter, mad scientist from back east, who came west because he wanted a place where he could use his electrostatically charged phlogistonic beam cannon and not have to worry about the police and the Pinkertons.
Because there's none of them out this way.
Well, there's less of them. How's that? Also, he likes robbing trains.
That's right. That was a good game. And Will, who do you have?
Friend at the fire.
I have Father Sam Johnson, who is a former tinkerer for Helstrom Industries, who's now kicking ass for the Lord.
Nice.
So happy.
Cool. All right, so a couple quick rules for you all. First off, again, we're using, if you're watching this and you're more familiar with Savage Worlds and not Deadlands Reloaded, if you know this concept of bennies, Savage Worlds Reloaded uses fate chips, and those are essentially just poker chips. And a white one works just like a benny, and a red one works like a benny, or alternatively, it works, you can add a d6 to your roll, an exploding d6. But if you get a red, I get to draw as the marshal. I get to draw an extra for my side. And a blue does the same thing as a red, except for I don't get to draw a fate chip. So that's one of the little quirks that kind of makes Savage Worlds Deadlands Reloaded kind of a cool game. Kind of differentiates it a bit from the other Savage Worlds. Okay, the other thing is just write this down now. So guts checks are use guts in place of spirit for fear checks, kind of like how if you've been playing Savage Worlds for a while, that's how it was done originally. But there's no guts in regular Savage Worlds. You use spirit checks. Well, Deadlands Reloaded uses guts. So on your skills, there should be a skill for guts. If you don't have it, you will be scared pretty easily. And you just should all write down -3 right now next to that somewhere. And I think Gracie is at a +1 already, so she's just -2 because the place we're starting is very, very scary. It's Dodge City. But let's get into that. I'm going to read the adventure. And this is now, after I fill in the information, the unexpected wedding of Professor Vandersmythe. I've randomly determined who is getting married tonight in the adventure. And when I'm done with the adventure tonight, I'm going to actually post the adventure on my blog site, livingforcrits.com. So you could play The Unexpected Wedding of Professor Vandersmythe as well if you want.
Well, dang, I ain't even met the betrothed.
Well, you're going to in a couple seconds. And if this is your first time watching one of my actual plays, I apologize.
God be with you.
Okay. So we should know right. Well, note right now that I randomly determined what everyone's role in the wedding was going to be. The one getting married is Professor Vandersmythe. The best man is Shady Doug Laveau. The officiant is Gracie Law. The wedding planner is Lopan. And Father Sam is the uninvited.
Ooh.
We're going to find out why, though, in a moment. And here we go. And I want to put some special thanks to everyone who contributed. I can't list you all out, but we had some great things through Twitter to stock this adventure. Your characters are experienced heroes, varmint slayers, abomination hunters, and well-known do-gooders in the Weird West. Your most recent exploits had you up in the town of Snakebite Junction working for Sheriff Bijan Frise. Sheriff Bijan Frise had a problem with a troop of intelligent devil bats masquerading as clowns. Your posse cleared out these creatures easily. The terrible abominations have been keeping local railroad foremen as victims in a hidden basement surrounded by vats full of sludge beneath their sweat lodge lair. Unfortunately, none of the victims survived. At the end of this exploit, however, one member of your team, Professor Vandersmythe, took a liking to a self-described Snakebite Junction local, Anna Kendrick. The two met shortly after the battle with the intelligent devil bats while both just happened to be shopping at the local Dirty Dick's Guns and Ammo store. This chance meeting soon became a more formal courtship. Anna Kendrick said that they worked as a lawyer in Snakebite Junction, but always dreamt of leaving for bigger and better things. The two have been inseparable ever since, although Anna Kendrick came with a bit of baggage. The entire Kendrick family, about 30 in total, they followed their kin and the rest of the posse to the next town, carting with them all their belongings in a wagon full of whiskey, that devil's water, in barrels, the only source of Kendrick family wealth. After arriving in Dodge City, the two decide to tie the knot. Professor Vandersmythe proposed by offering a very fine golden pocket watch full of lead and a giant box of peyote pops, which is a type of candy, apparently. I think it was Will, right? That was you, Will. Anna Kendrick loved candy. The two lovebirds have set a date today and have a romantic honeymoon planned in El Paso, old El Paso, where they plan to spend a full week horse racing to the railroad crossing. Don't know what that means.
Gracie, it's a euphemism.
Gracie Law performs. Is it really?
It is now. It is now.
I looked it up to make sure it wasn't X-rated. Is that crazy?
No, that's probably a good thing.
Yeah, that was Gracie Law.
Gracie Law agreed to perform this ceremony, with Shady Doug Laveau agreeing to stand next to Professor Vandersmythe so long as he got the dance with Anna Kendrick's kissing cousin. Lo Pan has spent several days putting the finishing touches on what will be a beautiful ceremony at the post office after an exciting after shindig to be held at a local Turkish bathhouse. For some reason, perhaps it's because of the most recent game of musical chairs, Father Sam was not invited to the wedding.
Happens every time.
You know, that musical chairs.
It's musical chairs roulette. One of them is a bomb strapped under it.
Ooh.
Your friend was lost. It was a hot mess.
So the five of your characters are all in the local post office, which, imagine a post office. It looks just like that. You have on one side, like, I guess where the teller would be. I'm just coming up with this on the fly here. And because you don't stop the postman even for weddings, they're still doing the whole mail collection thing, you know?
There's like horses coming in and out.
Yeah. Yeah. Did that happen? All right. So every couple seconds, an actual horse comes in, a couple droppings fall down. And you've got a whole bunch, that's gross, a whole bunch of the family, the Kendrick family, kind of like mulling about, and they're bringing in like large, what's it called, benches, kind of so they can sit and be ready. It's the most romantic scene ever. And at the front, you've got a very nervous Professor Cornelius Vandersmythe, and you've got next to him is Shady Doug. The wedding's actually, the actual ceremony is a couple hours away, but you're all just kind of getting nervous. I like that. Still a better love story than Twilight from Pit Viper 52. I agree.
Yes.
The wedding's a few hours away. Now, I think it's important to note, not that this should matter, but look at your gear and decide what you probably should be carrying at a wedding. Anything larger than a pistol, I think you can safely say, is not carried unless you have a reason to carry it.
I don't leave my electrostatically charged phlogistonic beam cannon anywhere.
So where is that, Mark?
It is slung over my back, obviously.
Jason Levine says, noting this is far from a typical wedding, and that is true. However, I think if you want it slung on your back, you're going to have to pay for that. So why don't you toss me a Benny? Actually, anyone that wants to keep a long arm needs to toss me a Benny and tell me, or a fate chip. Ugh, oops. Tell me which kind they're using, white or red. And they need to go ahead and tell me where it's hidden. It's just you, Mark, right?
I see the white one, but you already know where I'm putting it.
On your back, right?
Yep. It's not hidden at all.
Are you trying to dress it up at all to make it look a little better than just you have a gun on your back?
It's wearing a top hat.
Okay. Okay. I think that's fair. That could have been your best man, I guess.
You know.
So Father Sam has his Gatling shotgun, but it's he carries it around in sort of this leather-sided case thing. So the case itself is kind of a rigid leather box case type thing, and so it's in the post office, but it's kind of off to one side, leaning up against the wall, kind of out of the way, but easily accessible if needed.
Are you going to spend a fate chip for that?
Do I need to? I mean, I don't have it on me.
I think to have it near you, yeah, you're going to have to. If you want to have it in the adventure, spend a fate chip. And you know what? I'm going to go with Dead Man Walken's idea of the more powerful the gun, the higher the fate chip. So toss in your blue, buddy.
Ooh. Oh, no. All right. Yeah, because this gun is ridiculous. So it's definitely worth that.
I'm glad I got in early.
Yeah, I know. You, Dead Man Walken cut
darn
off.
Darn you, listeners.
It'll get worse.
Yeah, I know. It will only get worse. All right, so the bride to be, Anna Kendrick, is not in she's not in here yet. You're not sure where she's at. You know she's gonna be here at some point in time. So yeah, the family's all around. One thing with the Kendricks that makes it a little interesting, all their names begin with the letter M, except for Anna.
Okay.
And you haven't quite figured this out. You're so infatuated. In fact, I should hit you with this special rule now, Mark, okay?
Okay.
Actually, Mark, go ahead and take an extra white fate chip. Okay.
Okay.
And the reason I'm saying that here is because there is a new setting rule I'm using for this adventure called Smitten. And the player who is getting married is absolutely head over heels infatuated with the bride and fully intends to go through with the ceremony. There is nothing supernatural about this love connection. It's just you really like her a whole lot. And to represent this in-game, you have the vow major hindrance for this adventure only. And, you know, so it's unless some other reason would show you why not to do that.
Okay.
So it's going to be you want the wedding to go off. You can't just say, hey, I'm done. You know, this isn't going to work for me.
So let me get this straight. The groom wants to marry the bride. That's shocking.
No, playing with you all is proof enough to me I need a rule for this because I've played with you all before. I know if I don't put a rule in saying the husband needs to marry the bride, it's not going to happen or get anywhere near happening.
Oh, no.
So, yes, I had to put mechanics in to ensure that Mark got married.
Okay.
Anyway, so everyone's in there. They're all having a good old time, kind of waiting, pacing, a little nervous. And out of nowhere, Maureen runs in. So everyone knows Maureen, right? Maureen is like, she's like, it's terrible. It's terrible. Professor Cornelius, you won't believe what happened.
Whom is Maureen?
You know Maureen. Who is Maureen?
Your sister.
That's right, Craig. Get a white fate chip. All right. So Maureen is the sister of Anna Kendrick. Maureen Kendrick.
Okay. Like,
she just says, "There's no cake. The cake is missing."
All right. Well, that's easy enough to deal with.
Is it really easy enough to deal with? You need to deal with this, Professor.
I put my finger on her lips and I turn over my shoulder to where my gun is and I say, we really gotta leave the family behind. And then I turn to Lo Pan and I say, Lo Pan, as the wedding planner, I do believe this is your area of expertise.
Yes, it is. All right, I will see what I can do about taking care of that. What happened to the cake?
It wasn't delivered.
Was it Highwayman, Maureen?
No, it just wasn't. It wasn't. You need to go find out.
Are you sure it wasn't Highwayman? It's always Highwayman.
Maybe it was Highwayman, but I don't know.
All right. Well, I will go to the cake place then. Cake store. See why it wasn't delivered.
Are you gonna walk there? Are you going by yourself?
How far is it? Like, where exactly is it?
It's on the other side. You're in Dodge City. It's down by like where they carve up the buffalo. That seems to make sense.
Yeah.
So it's buffalo in Buffalo Cave. Alley.
That's a landmark that everyone knows.
Yes.
Yes.
Go to where the buffalo are carved and turn left.
So who's all going?
I think as the best man, it's my duty to make sure my best friend's day goes off without a hitch. So I will accompany Lopan to the figure out what's wrong with this cake business.
Okay.
Father Sam will go as well, since, you know, I didn't get invited to this thing. The best I can hope for is actually some cake. So
we didn't want you here.
Yeah, I want to make sure this part goes off without a hitch, because if there's no cake, there's nothing in this whole day for me.
I pull Doug aside and I say, see if you can lose the father.
As you're like standing there kind of trying to follow off, Maureen's like, you weren't invited. I can't stop you from coming to the post office.
Oh, the shepherd of the Lord is welcome wherever he goes. Read your good book, little girl.
Yeah, sorry. So Pit Viper 52 said the priest, the one who wasn't invited to the wedding. That's true. It's random rolling of who got uninvited. So believe me, as I said, I wanted this to be the wedding of Lopan, but I didn't get my wish, because that'd be an awesome title to an adventure. So we can't get what we want sometimes. Okay, so you guys all march in order across town. I should note, you know, the Dodge City in the Weird West is a bit different than what it would be from, you know, actual history. It's in this disputed territory, which is not quite the North and not quite the South. And there's always, you know, a lot of trouble and just brooding in this city. So right now, even though it's mid-morning, it's sort of dreary out, and the rain is cold. And it gives you a little shiver down your spine as you walk through on what should be a beautiful wedding day. It's not. It's not a beautiful wedding day at all. And you make it to Buddy's Bakery, and inside you see a rather rotund, just short man, maybe 5 feet tall. He's just kind of sitting there crying into his hands.
All right. Well, I'm gonna ask him what's wrong.
What's wrong? There's no cake.
Why? Where is the cake?
It was stolen.
Isn't it was stolen. Bakery?
It was stolen, maybe by highwaymen.
Highwaymen, you say?
Yes, maybe.
I think we're going to deal with this.
And I tried to get more sugar to make more, but there's just Daryl down the street's charging $100 for a sack of sugar.
You say Daryl be, what's the word I'm looking for?
I don't know. What? What? Expensive Daryl?
the price. He's jacked up the price. Sure.
Oh, he's price gouging.
Price gouging. That's
the exactly what he's doing.
Price. You see Daryl be price gouging the sugar.
He is. And I'd love to make another cake, and Lord knows I can make a cake in 2 hours, but not for $100 in sugar. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry I couldn't have the wedding cake for this fine Kendrick Vandersmythe wedding.
You just need us to duck. I'll take care of it.
Okay.
So if we get you the sugar, you can make the cake in time for the glorious nuptials to come.
I could make a jerky-flavored cake.
Mmm. I'm intrigued.
What kind of cake was
all the rage?
It was like a very nice, like, just cake. It was like a traditional, like maybe like a little bit of like an almond cake or something. That sounds Western, almond cake.
And when was it taken? When did the highwaymen come in?
Just an hour ago. I think everyone's the same place right now. I'm sorry.
Where'd they go?
I don't know. It's. I couldn't track them. It's raining outside and drizzly, and you know we don't have time to go hunt for a cake. There's a wedding. I have a cake to deliver to a Turkish bathhouse in 3 hours.
Too bad Pedro Fire isn't here. He could track him down real fast. But
he's not here.
He's not here.
Huckster showed up instead.
It's a shame. He's a Tucker. I think, what, anybody else have any chalking ability?
I think we should just go to the sugar guy.
And shake him down? All right.
I can try to persuade him.
I'm sure he can be persuaded somehow.
Yeah.
Well, it's not that far. It's just down a little bit, like maybe another block down in one of the muddy western streets. So we're all going down that way. So you guys all just kind of march down. I'm doing the little hand marching thing for myself. I don't know why I'm doing that, but just for my own purposes. And you see a store. It says Eliza's out front. And inside is a rather burly looking guy, you know, kind of buff, you know, and he's just in there tending store. He's stacking canned goods at the moment.
His name is Elias?
No, his name, the store is called Eliza's, and his name, according to Buddy, is Daryl.
Daryl, yeah. I'm going to walk up to Dale.
Hi there!
Hello, Dale.
What can I interest you in? I have canned goods here.
Well, Dale, we'd be looking for some sugar.
Oh, I have a great deal on sugar.
Do you?
I'm sorry. I just saw Jason just put up expensive Daryl. I'm going to use that somewhere else. I have to.
Yeah.
That's his nickname. Yeah. I have sugar. I had the last sack of sugar in all of Dodge City.
Why is there only one sack of sugar?
I don't know. It's been there was Highwayman. The entire shipment of sugar was grabbed.
Does Highwayman be getting around pretty good?
Yes, I've heard that not only Highwayman, but you know, maybe raiders from the south came up and took. I don't know. All I can tell you is I have a fine sack of sugar for $150 to sell you.
You know what sugar is, right? I mean,
Well, do you know what sugar is?
I mean, it's sugar. It's not like gold.
True. Gold isn't worth as much as sugar when you're in a town with a wedding happening soon.
Oh, is that how we're going to play it? How about I play it for it?
Okay. Okay, I'm up for that, maybe.
All right.
What is your gambling, Andy?
My gambling is a D6.
Okay. I'm gonna give him a roll here too. So you guys sit there and you're gonna roll off here, right? Yeah. You won't give the full gambling rules here. So, all right. So I've rolled.
Okay.
Beat a five.
Wait, I have to roll a wild die too.
That's true. You do.
No dice.
You're gonna spend the fate chip?
Sure, I'll spend the fate chip.
White or red?
Red, you're hitting one extra d6.
Red, you add a d6 what you've already rolled, if you want.
I'm gonna do that because
okay.
I only rolled a three, so.
A red, I get to take one. And I get one.
Try again. It's eight now.
All right, so you beat him, and he doesn't look happy about it. So you may have won the gambling, but he's not thrilled. He's like, I think you cheated.
Do you have any proof of that?
No.
Well,
do you have any proof you didn't cheat?
Come now, Daryl.
I'll drop the price, but it's not free. $75.
Daryl.
Yeah?
The Lord does not like people that go back on their word, Daryl. And I'll put a kind of a friendly arm around his shoulder and kind of pull him in tight. The Lord is watching you, Daryl.
All right.
A less friendly hand on my gun.
All right. Well, before the gun, why don't you get, so Will, why don't you give me a persuasion roll?
All right. So I'm looking at.
Do you have the skill for persuasion?
I do. D6.
So you roll a D6 and a wild die with it. So a second D6 with it.
All right. 8.
All right. So you beat it with a raise, and he's like, "You know what? You're right. You're right. Before I was known as Expensive Daryl, I was known as Reasonably Priced Daryl."
Dun, dun, dun.
That was once upon a time, though. I swear, though, I can't. This is the last bag of sugar in all town. I'll give it to you, but only because I want to go to heaven so bad to see my mama.
You're a good man, Daryl. You're a good man.
I'm sorry. Daryl, let me tell you, after we get this whole wedding business figured out, I'm going to figure out what happened to that sugar for you. Get those sugar lines going again.
You're
going to
get the highwayman for me?
Yeah. We can't have sugar shortages in Dodge City.
This is agreed. I agree. Oh. You're a bunch of fine people.
He gives Sugar's you the sack. All
they got. He is. Sugar and buffalo hide. He gives you the sack of sugar.
Thank you very much.
He is the sugar daddy. All right. So I'm going to make the assumption you're going to take the sugar back to all the way back, right?
That's yep. Right.
Okay. You do that, and you know, the baker, Buddy the baker, is thrilled. Says, well, I can get a real fast cake together for you, and you know, maybe something special, and I'll toss in like maybe some tequila flavored frosting for you, and it'd be great, wouldn't it?
I like the sound of that.
All right, that's great. I'm gonna get work on it right now, guys. Thanks.
The secret ingredient is tears. His happy tears.
I don't have any water either. Just tears.
He gets baking, and you know, you guys all kind of go back to the post office. I would imagine. So once you're at the post office, of course, some of your own guests arrive. People you all invited. So I'd like to know maybe one or two people you each invited to the wedding. So. Let's start with you know, that quizzical look on your face. Mark, who else did you invite to the wedding besides your gun?
I invited my rival.
Really?
Yes. Professor Henry Blatherskythe.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, cool. That's a good invite. He's there. He has like a villain goatee. You know,
and his wife is hideous.
What's is his wife here?
Yes.
What's his wife's name?
Patricia.
Patricia?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm giving you a fate chip, Mark. You get another white one.
All right.
Who did Lopan invite to the wedding?
Lopan invited his boss from Shen Fan. I can't remember his name. What was his name?
I have no idea what his name was.
Remember, it was the warlord from.
I have it up. I have it up. It's King or something. King.
There you go.
Yeah, it's King. Warlord.
So King. King. The warlord it was Kang. Is here. Yep. Okay. All right. He's off in the corner. He's brooding. He might be hatching
him and his bodyguards.
Okay. How many bodyguards do you have?
At least four.
Four bodyguards.
He's the warlord of Shan Fan.
Okay. That invite was for a +2 only.
What was that?
That invite was for a +2 only.
I know, that's true. All right, so I'll tell you what. He brings the bodyguards, and I'm giving you an extra. You get a white one, but all four bodyguards are brought in, and Maureen very angrily removes them and makes them stay outside. She will not let them in the wedding.
Okay.
Because that you didn't get four. You got two. Sorry. All right. So, Shady Doug Laveau, who did you invite?
Walks with fire.
That's right. No, plays with fire, and I did. But you see, plays with fire is too busy leading the tribe now. He's after his exploits last time. He was promoted.
So he's not here.
No, but he sent his son.
Okay, what's his son's name?
Metals with Embers.
Metals with Embers. Nice. Nice. Okay. All right. Gracie Law, who did she invite?
Gracie invited a woman named Delphine, the talk of the Weird West. Well known in gossip circles, she's like basically just a celebrity, and secretly Gracie wants to interview her or like get details about her for her gossip zine that's getting brought around by like pony mail in the West. Nice.
Okay, well she's like all fancy then and stuff.
Oh yeah, like big like furs, very okay, much she's, sticking out.
She's in the corner and she's okay. She's having a drink. She's having you know,
fanning herself.
Yeah, for sure.
Scowling.
All right, you get a white fate chip and you get a red fate chip, okay?
Cool.
And Father who is Father Sam in having here?
Well, so
just kidding, you don't get anyone, you weren't invited. Go ahead. Who
there was some confusion since Father Sam's invitation got lost in the mail.
Oh yeah.
So he just sort of took it upon himself. So he's got six little orphan kids from the mission, because he thought it'd be neat to kind of bring them in and, you know, free lunch is always good for orphan kids. So there's six little tots. They're running around with bare feet and threadbare clothing. And, you know, they're running back and forth, making a big mess, running into people, that sort of thing.
Okay.
Man, you invited this guy.
So they're, yeah, they're, it's just a mess.
What do you mean you invited this guy?
All right, so
you're gonna have to talk later.
I think it's time for the wedding. You know, the time is has come. All your guests are here, and the ceremony begins. And you see that there is a lone post office worker. He's a typical postman, looks like Kevin Costner. He's off in the corner right now, and he's playing like a harpsichord or something in the corner. And while he does that, brought in just for this, it's like, dun, 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 dun. All right, and they bring in, at the front, you've got, you know, Professor Cornelius Vandersmythe there, and Shady Doug next to him, and she comes in, and Anna Kendrick looks very similar to, the Anna Kendrick you'd see from the movie Pitch Perfect, save for the fact that she is missing a pinky on her left hand, and it's bandaged.
What?
Yes. And otherwise, the same. And she's comes in, and she's in a very nice dress. What color is her dress, Andy? What?
Anna Kendrick's dress? I mean...
What color is it? Quick.
Gotta be pure white.
Okay. So it's a pure white dress, and what was that?
I said, you're damn right.
And she's like, you know, she looks so happy, you know, and she just kind of like steps and steps and steps. And she comes up right in front of you and she's just beaming, Mark. She looks so happy. And with that, I think we need to start the wedding. So so how does Gracie kick this off?
Gracie, until the ceremony had started, had been like spinning the barrel of her pistols, a little nervous about this. She's not a man of God and she hasn't done this before, but she's been practicing, so she steps forward. Weirdly beloved, she says, we've come here in the presence of demons, ghosted out steam engines, and lots of raised dead to celebrate today about the joining together of this man and this woman in holy and matrimony. She goes on and on, blah, blah, blah. I think someone in the crowd goes, skip a bit, brother. And she gets
Father, to Father Sam is nodding encouragingly.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, you've like been coaching me, definitely. You got this. Into this union, Anna Kendrick, and Professor, I forget your first name, Professor?
Cornelius
Vandersmythe, now come to be joined. If any of you can show just cause why they may not be lawfully wed, speak now or forever hold your peace. And Gracie looks like very excited whether someone will say no.
Does anyone shout?
I'm going to glare out at the crowd and like put my hand on the butt of my gun.
All right, Mark. There does seem to be someone that's sort of staring up at you a little bit right now, okay? And Professor Henry Batherskite is just kind of looking at you like maybe he might do it. So I think we need a little test of wills action here. So I think we need just to face this off. So let's have an opposed spirit roll. You need to stare him down or he's going to totally call this out.
All right. Get to use my fancy old West D6 here.
Out of five again.
I rolled a 4, but I'm going to drop my blue fate chip.
Nice. Roll a D6.
And that adds 3, so that I got a 7.
All right, so he goes to stand up, and you look at him, and he's like...
Creep step down.
And as you do that, like, Kang over in the corner, like, slowly flips you both the bird, you know, with the wind-up thing.
Oh, my gosh.
So it was Dead Man Walking, toss that in. I think, who did he flip the bird off to? Let's see. I think he flipped it off to Shady Doug. For whatever reason, he doesn't like you, Shady Doug. So you're annoyed by that. Take a -1 to your next action, Andy.
I cock my gun. Just pull the hammer back.
The -1 to cocking your gun, unfortunately.
It goes off.
All right, so is this time for the vows then?
I think so. Did the dearly beloved here, did they write their own vows?
I think they did.
Of course they did.
Did the YouTube chat room write their vows? Not yet. Okay.
Anyone in the YouTube chat write any good vows here?
Not yet.
No, not yet. Mark, it's on you right now. You better toss some stuff in here. What are you saying, Mark?
Y'all suck. That's what I'm saying. So the professor... Kind of, you know, he's still staring down at his little rival there, and you know, glaring him down, and you know, Anna has to kind of tug at his coat sleeve. He's like, oh, right. Anna dear, since I met you 3 whole weeks ago, you have been the light of my life.
I'm gonna shed a tear.
I'm sorry. What was that?
I'm going to shed a tear. Please continue.
And perhaps this union will be the greatest invention since my dear gun here, Betsy. I would be most honored if you would be my
wife. You sure will be, sweetie!
Until the day that my damn inventions separate us.
That day! I'm sorry. Continue, please, sweetie.
No, that was it.
Oh, that was it? That's all I get? Really? Okay. Okay, well, I knew getting into this, I was marrying not just you, but Betsy, too. And I'm okay with that. I'm fine with plural marriage as long as one of the members has a gun. I do promise to love you and cherish you forever and ever. And we're going to have the sweetest wedding ever. The sweetest, most sugary wedding of all time. It's going to be great.
And she wipes her eyes. And as she wipes her eyes, you notice like her bandage has come off a little bit. And like as she wipes her eyes, actually a little bit of goop that's coming out of her pinky. And no one else sees it, Mark, but I need you to make – you're it's freaking you out a little bit. You need to make a fear check, so make a guts roll.
We have a -3 to guts, so what I do, I have to take -3 off of the die roll?
Yes, off of both, yes.
That's a 0.
No way!
I'm gonna spend one of those white bennies of mine.
Okay.
Reroll these dice. That's only a 2, so it's still a failure.
All right, so.
-3 is brutal.
Mark, you're actually shaken for a minute. You're shaken. You are effectively shaken, and you're staring there. And no one else sees this, but you see as she wipes her eye, like there's – like you know how like one of those things you'd swat against the window with like be a hand like one of those things you like has like a jelly hand, imagine that but out of her finger And then when she notices you look at it, it slowly retracts into her finger. And she just puts, she just closes her hand. And she's like, my sweetie. And she puts her hand down.
Do I see him being weirded out?
You all see him just stall, but you don't see him say anything. And Mark, you really don't think you can talk about it.
I slap him in the back.
I just think to myself, my, that is unsettling.
So they both, she looks at you, Gracie, to see if you're going to finish this off.
Will you, Cornelius Vandersmythe, have Anna Kendrick to be your wife?
Yes, of course.
That's right.
And will you, Anna Kendrick?
Yes!
Well, I believe you may now kiss the bride, sir.
She turns and looks at you, Mark, and there's this beautiful look in her eyes.
It's not a hungry look, is it?
No, it does. No, Mark, make a notice roll.
Oh, crud. I have a D4 in notice.
Cool.
Like the pitiful. Aw.
Nope.
There's a lot of honey going on for this poor
you
profession
just,
today.
You just close your eyes as she just carries you forward with her lilting voice. Kiss me! she's like
everyone.
Okay. It is not the sweetest kiss. It is not the messiest kiss. There is a little bit of tongue or something, but once it's done, the wedding is sealed. And everyone starts to clap and they say, "Yay, this is great." All the fam members are clapping.
It doesn't like feel gooey or anything, right?
Your mouth?
No, like, well, you know, because I saw that weird stuff coming out of her finger. Like, she doesn't, like, feel like, you know, less than solid.
I would like you to give me a strength roll.
Strength?
Yes.
Awesome. Because a guy named Cornelius Vandersmith really hits the weights.
Since you said that, take -2 off of your roll.
Oh, snap.
Thanks, Jim.
This might be hashtag ruin Mark tonight.
So I rolled a 4 on my D4. Does that pop?
It explodes. Roll it again.
All right. And 4 + 3 = 7. -2 = 5.
You succeed. So you are just buff enough that you did have a girlfriend once.
Oh.
And you don't remember a kiss like that.
In a good way or a bad way?
Not in the most pleasant way, but you know, you really do love this girl, and maybe it's different.
Sure.
Maybe your first girlfriend just didn't know how to kiss properly.
That absolutely could be the case.
There is
it's okay, son. Everything changes after you get married. It's okay. You'll get used to it.
Oh no!
I've
done it twice.
The rest of your characters all turn around and you see her clapping and it's time for the shindig at the Turkish bathhouse.
Let's party and stuff.
All right, so everyone, I like that. So Crimson Photo G says it's your wedding night. It's the feels. Aw.
No.
So,
aw. That's Andrew, Katie.
Oh, is it? I didn't know.
I think so.
Is it? Okay. Is that Andrew? Oh, that's nice. All right. I'm just used to seeing him, like, you know, not be that name. All right. So you all go outside. It's time for the rice throwing ceremony. That's always a good ceremony in front of a post office, right? As you're, like, pushing past a horse coming in and, like, it is Andrew, is it? And a horse comes in. Kevin Costner packs up his harpsichord and outside and there is rice being thrown. And as this is happening – you all hear, Sam! Sam!
Yes? Who calls?
No, not you!
Oh.
Her! And there's a man a rather tall man, like in his early 20s, and he's pointing at Anna, at Anna Kendrick.
That, sir, is my wife.
That's Sam! That's my betrothed.
No, that, sir, is my wife. And her name is Anna.
Oh, that can't be. Sam, why? And all of the family members turn to him and just start yelling and throwing rice at him and say, get out of here! Get out of here! You're not my husband! This is my husband! And she just grabs you and your gun.
I'm going to go and escort this gentleman out of the off-premises.
Wait!
Gracie's going to come investigate. This sounds like gossip.
So Sam is flanked actually by a trio of like long coat wearing guys, like long jackets, long dusters, and they all look pretty grim. So Andy, you go over and so does Darcy, and he's like, Sam, this has got to be her. We tracked her all the way here.
If there's three of them, I'll go over that way too.
Okay.
Look, buddy, I don't know what you're trying to pull here, but my buddy here is getting married. He just got married, and we're about to have a party, and you're not invited.
Well, so, that's my fiance, Sam. My name's Pat.
Well, not anymore, Pat, because she's got married. Somebody
else. Note the gender neutral names. The adventure works either way, husband or wife.
Pat, tell me more about this Sam you know. Where are you coming from?
I came all the way from Snakebite Junction. We tracked her here, along with all you folk.
Our dear Anna here has a big family. I think one of them would have told us.
I don't know any family. She was just a traveler, and she went missing up in Snakebite Junction. I've been looking for her. It's got to be her. It looks just like her. Looks just like her.
Well, you know, small world. And it's not her, so scram.
She's got one of those faces.
Andy, go ahead and make a persuasion roll or an intimidation roll. You pick which one you want to have that sort of real mellow small world scram comment.
I got taunt.
That's not it. So I guess you're rolling a D4 minus 2 for not being trained in either of these.
I can try persuasion, but I would let you happily fail. If you
yeah, let him happily fail first.
Yeah, let me give it a shot.
Jeremy's rooting on Shady.
That's a 4 on a D4.
Ooh!
Maybe
another 4 on a D4.
Ooh, exploding foursiders!
Yay. That is a 4, 8, 10, 8.
Nice.
That's a success with a raise, and yeah, he's right. Like, I'm not going away so easily, but the wedding's over, I guess. I'll just leave this go for now. But I'm not done in this town. I'm not done with Sam. Love always finds a way. Come on, boys. And he walks off. They walk off like in formation. He looks back over his shoulder. He's like,
yeah. Don't let the saloon doors hit you on the way out, sir.
That's right!
I just pat my gun as he looks back.
Come on, sweetie, it's time for the shindig. Let's go.
Let's go.
We boogie.
All right.
All right. So you guys make your way to the only Turkish bathhouse in all of
the United States of
Dodge City. No, actually, they were very, very popular in the Victorian
That's
era.
That's true.
So, and the way it looks inside is that as you go inside, there's sort of a central chamber, and off to the left or right would be where, you know, the men's side and the women's side, and there's a little pool in the central chamber, and you see that there's a spread, maybe, I don't know, let's find, Lopan, what did you have prepared for tonight?
The finest of Chinese cuisine that I could get in this town.
Okay.
There's some dumplings. There's like a whole roast pig.
Okay. All right. How about and to drink? What's the drink tonight?
Well, I would say there's probably some beer and some whiskey, considering we're in the Old West.
Okay, beer and whiskey, classy. How about decorations?
Yeah, The only decorations I could find was red, white, and blue streamers from the 4th of July celebration.
And guns.
And guns. There you go.
All right, so you walk into the gaudiest, most America 4th of July ever in a Turkish bathhouse. All the streamers are kind of like soggy already, and they're dripping onto the floor because of all the hot steam. Because every once in a while, the guy who runs it, who's an Irishman, like goes and heats up the water, and it's real steamy and stuff. And you know, the baker comes in with the cake, and everyone's really excited. You know, this is looks like it's going to be a great event, great gala. Metals with Embers is here. Kang is here. His bodyguards aren't here. You know, and Delphine is here in the corner, and she is talking to both Professor Henry Batherskite and his horribly ugly looking wife, Patricia. And then you've got four orphan kids off in the corner.
There were six.
There were six orphans.
There were six. A couple on the way.
There were six orphan kids in the corner, but now there's four. And say, "Oh, this is so beautiful. I'm so happy. We should just start dancing now."
What's the music you provided, Lopan?
Kevin Costner brought his harpsichord.
Jumping harpsichord.
The
tunes.
The question is, did he, Craig? Did he? I think you need to make a smart roll to remember that.
I got a five.
All right, so Kevin Costner comes in. He's a postman named Kevin Costner at this point, and he is playing his harpsichord. And it's kind of nice. It's a nice little event over there in the corner. You know, like Delphine is talking with Patricia now, and they're talking. The three orphan kids in the other corner, they're over there just enjoying some cake. There's only three over there. You only see three in the room.
I better start looking around for the other ones.
That's a wise idea. So how do you do that?
They're not going to rent you any more orphan kids if you don't bring them all back.
They come out of my pay if I don't.
All right, so you can make it. You can make a go ahead and make a notice roll. Okay. Unfortunately, we got to stop you for a second. Dead Man Walking made a comment. We got to take in here. You know, your character is Father Sam in the Old West, but the fact that Kevin Costner is playing Korn's Love and Meth right now is causing a temporal like anomaly in the room. So your character hearing like, you know, music from the modern age is just throwing you off. So minus two to your actions.
To everybody?
No, just to him.
Just him. Okay.
Because we know Father Sam is not like the band Korn. He likes actual Korn, but not the band Korn.
This sounds like the devil's music.
It is.
So I rolled a four. It explodes, right?
It explodes, but it's minus two.
All right, so I got a seven minus two is five.
Okay, so you do not find any children besides the three. And they're just sitting there, and they're like picking at the cake right now. And you see all three of them look at you.
Where are your friends? Well, they're orphan kids, so I can kind of smack them around a little bit. So get the cake out of your mouth. Where are your friends?
A woman comes over, you know, a rather short woman, you know, kind of a little, I wouldn't say skinny, but, you know, she looks like she's been out in the sun for a while. Yeah, she has like a real, like almost leathery looking face to her, you know. Oh,
Matilda Kendrick, the grandmother?
Yes, she is Matilda Kendrick, the grandmother.
Ma'am?
Just leave them alone. They're fine.
Well, these ones are.
Yeah, they're all fine.
Do you know that? Do you know where the other three are, ma'am?
There only were three. And look at them. They look good to me.
Okay. Back up a step or two.
Eat some more cake. Eat some. It's okay. It's okay. Eat it.
Father Sam was eyeing the cake earlier, but now appetite is completely gone.
Yeah, the kids just eating cake and enjoying themselves. Lopan, you get a tap on your shoulder.
Okay.
And Kang is staring at you.
Sir?
He whispers in your ear in Chinese. He's like, it's time that his guards come in here. You better make sure they can come in. He doesn't feel safe here. Not with the steam, the streamers, and all these America guns.
That's fine. I'm sure they can come in.
We'll go get them.
All right, I'll go outside and get his guards. I'll go outside and get his guards.
Okay, there's a guard outside by himself standing there.
I ask him where the other ones are.
He kind of shrugs.
All right, well, I tell him to come on in.
He comes in. Kang looks at you. He's like, there was more than one.
There's only one left. I don't know where the other ones went.
What?
You must not have paid them or something.
This will not go well for you if there's just one of my guards here and you let the other three go missing.
I don't know what to tell you. They're gone. They... Ask him. He was with them.
Who?
The guard was with the other guards, wasn't he?
They start yelling at each other loudly and back and forth in Chinese. And Professor Cornelius, you look over at Anna Kendrick. She's looking at you and she's like, I don't want any fighting at my wedding. Please, can them stop, please?
Yes, Dale. Hold on. I'm going to go over and I'm going to be like, gentlemen, could you please bring the tone down?
Kang looks at you and is like, for now. Only because it's your special day.
This is a bathhouse. Behave. And then I will and turn and walk away.
Greasy slides in with her like Gatling pistol. I hear there's a mystery afoot. Why don't you fellas tell me everything you know?
Kang looks at you and says, I had four guards that came with me to this wedding. Only one remains.
I had six orphans that came with me. Only three remain.
Three? I see two.
Only two remain. A mystery is afoot indeed.
I still haven't found it. This cousin I'm supposed to be dancing with.
Oh, you see the cousin.
Oh.
Actually, the cousin's really looking at you right now.
Craig,
what's the name of the cousin?
Me?
Molly.
Molly. All right. While Darcy's over there, Molly's kind of sidling up to next to you, Andy, and she reaches into a purse and she pulls out, I snuck this in just for you. I heard you wanted to dance. And she has like a muffin in her hand and she's giving it to you.
Thank you, miss.
Thank you.
What for?
Let's dance.
All right. Let's dance.
All right, so she takes her onto the dance floor, and she's watching, and she's, are you going to eat the muffin?
While we dance? I'm sorry, I just wasn't not accustomed to eating and dancing at the same time.
It's fine, you're allowed.
Can I look at the muffin? And
sure.
See if there's anything outwardly.
It looks like a corn muffin. It's kind of crumpled and it's a little damp from being in someone's pocket for a while.
This is like a one bite or two bite muffin.
It's like a two bite muffin.
All right, I'll take a bite.
Man, you got guts, dude. All right, so
I didn't see the weird finger thing.
Yeah, it's true. All right, so do a bite of that muffin, and it is the sweetest, most just cloyingly, just overly sugared muffin you ever taste. In fact, in the center of it, you swear like actual sugar is in your mouth.
Oh. Well, this is quite the muffin here. Do I see other muffins like on the tables?
No, you don't. No, you want the last remaining orphan is eating cake.
So that
Wait, what?
There's a kid in the corner. He's like, oh.
You don't cake. Mind me asking, Miss Molly, is it?
Yeah.
What the? Where'd you get this muffin from?
I brought it with me.
Oh.
I heard you wanted to dance.
Well, yes.
That's your tradition, yes?
Muffins while dancing?
Oh, no.
I'm not exactly sure where you got that idea, but...
That's what Anna said, to bring the muffin.
The muffin.
I'm going to be excused now. And she sort of steps away. While this is happening, Gracie, you're talking with Kang.
Yeah.
Like, I had four guards. Then I had one. And now he's gone while you've been talking with me.
Any of your guards have a sweet tooth?
Perhaps. It's been a long trip here from Shanfan.
Is there still an orphan left?
Yes.
But words I thought I'd never say in that succession.
Yes, there's still an orphan left.
Okay, before... I would like to try to ask get some information out of the orphan. How does that cake taste?
Buddy? As you're walking over, you're walking that way, Professor Henry Bathurst kind of nods you in the shoulder and was like, excuse me, you're Gracie Law, yes?
Yes.
Were you talking to my wife? I can't seem to find Patricia.
Is Delphine around?
She's right there. You see Delphine is off in the corner and she's eating a bowl of some kind of candy she's found.
Are these the,
They're Skittles.
The whatever pops, the,
Peyote Pops.
Peyote Pops.
Yeah, they're Peyote Pops.
That explains a lot.
Goodness.
The boy, so you kind of push past and the orphan's still sitting there with like all this cake and he's just leaning against the wall kind of sick right now. This is great.
Have I noticed the disappearing people, Jim?
Yeah, you noticed that at this point in time, Metals with Embers, four bodyguards, Patricia, and five orphans are gone. But the entirety you can tell of the family is still here.
I'm gonna turn to my blushing bride. Anna dear, is it me or has half of our reception party disappeared?
No, must be you. Definitely you. You ready to dance some more?
Of course, darling.
Goodness.
Certainly.
So back to dancing.
As I like kind of let her drag me out, I'm looking around. Oh, where's the harpsichord player?
So you do see that there's two. So the room has three passageways, essentially. There's an exit, and there's a passageway that would take you into the men's area for bathing and the women's area for bathing.
Are all the family members still in the room?
Yes, you count all the family members in the room, except for a couple. You know, you do think there were a couple extra family members are at the wedding, but, you know, if there were 15 family members at the wedding, you're only counting 12 in here right now.
I'm going to excuse myself to the little ladies' room. I'm just going to take a quick peek in the women's side of the Turkish bathhouse.
All right. As you slip away, are you going to try to do this without being seen, or are you...
Yeah, I would like to.
Let's do some stealth rolling then.
All right. That's not really her game, but she's willing to try it.
Sure.
So I'm doing it untrained.
All right. You have fate chips to spend.
Yeah. Is it a D4 for an untrained thing?
Yes.
Okay. So let me just roll it and see what happens.
That's
the one.
Well, yes, you're a wild die also.
Oh, yes, the D6. Thank God. Oh, lovely.
You want to spend one of your fate chips.
That's what I'm going to do.
Red, blue, or white?
I'm going to spend a white.
All right.
So let's roll that again. Wow.
You want to spend another fate chip?
No, I think she's just terrible at this. That's legit.
All right, she's walking over, and the sister Maureen kind of comes out of the bathhouse side, and she just kind of bumps right into you, and she's like, oh, you're Gracie. Oh, you know what? You helped us so much earlier. Thank you so much. Have you had cake yet?
I'm trying to watch my girlish figure.
Well, why don't you come with me and you can watch me have cake?
I assume she's like got her, arm around me or something.
Yeah, she's actually stepping in front of you, and as you move to the side, she kind of moves to the side.
Ah.
She's doing this as you kind of...
Well, I was actually hoping to use the powder room or get a mirror,
Oh, there's an outhouse here. You wouldn't do that inside. What do you think this is?
Okay. I guess I'm going to go watch her eat cake for a minute.
Hey, Jim?
Yes?
So, ever since that strange kiss, the professor has been rolling through his brain why that taste was oddly familiar.
Okay.
Can I roll like chemistry or weird science to try to identify this?
Sure, I would let you roll that. I would let you roll that.
All right. Weird science. Come on. I hate my dice. I hate them so much. I'm spending a white penny to re-roll them. A 7.
Okay. So the taste on your lips when you kissed your dear Anna Kendrick has it almost tastes a little like when you one time tried a wheatgrass shot.
A what?
A shot of wheatgrass. It had a very grassy taste to it.
Uh-huh. Interesting.
Maybe she chews.
Maybe. That must be it.
Speaking of chewing, this muffin that I ate, is it having any effects?
No, but you do notice that standing over in the corner, there's several of the fam members are looking at you right now. They're kind of sizing you up.
Is Molly one of them?
Yeah, Molly's one of them.
Okay. I'm gonna go ask her to dance again.
Oh, okay. She comes over. She's just dancing with you.
All right, dance, and I noticed, Miss Molly, that your family over there in the corner, they been looking at me, kind of weird. Like, did they?
Oh, they're not looking at you weird. They love to see just such a fine and shady individual like you in the room.
Well, I am awful shady.
Craig, your boss is missing.
I'm in charge, yay.
The great Hang is missing now.
I just got promoted. All right, I'll go to I'm going to head towards the men's side then.
Okay. Are you going to be doing this without out of sort of view, or are you going to be trying to be seen?
I'll try to go stealthy.
All right, give me a stealth roll, sir.
Take a white chip.
All right.
That's a 5.
All right, so you slip out, and you're in the men's side of the bathhouse. It's quite steamy in here. And you see there's a bunch of, like, hot tubs going, how you don't know. But I'd like you to make a notice roll in here. So the room is a big circular room, a large drain in the middle, a couple smaller drains on the outside, and it's ringed by 8 tubs. No one's in them. They're all just roiling as if something's blowing air through them. And a lot of steam coming up. Give me your notice roll.
Both exploded, so I ended up being an 11.
You hear the sound of choking and gagging through the drain.
Through the drain?
In the drain below.
Okay. Can I...
It's not Jesus. Or is... No, it's not.
Can I get down through the drain? Can I pull the drain up?
Yeah, you can pull the drain up.
All right, I'm going to pull it up. What do I see? What do I see down there?
You dip your head down into the drain, and you look, and you're in. It's a large, almost like cave-like room below, like an old cellar, and you see pipes and all sorts of workings that would maybe be powering the this ghost rock powered Turkish bathhouse. And the other thing you see is pretty awful. I need you to make a guts roll before I describe it. A -2 penalty. So you had a -5 penalty total.
That's a 2.
You want to spend a fate chip?
Yeah, I'll spend a white chip.
Okay.
Since I have a bunch. That's a 5. Or no, that's a, with a -3, that is a 2.
Okay. All right. I'm going to give you a choice here. Okay.
Yeah. Good.
You can let a squeak so you aren't facing the -2 and be heard, and you can describe what happened, or you cannot.
It doesn't matter. I'll
I'm torn.
Quick.
That's quick. Fine. You do whatever. That's fine.
All right. All right. So looking down, okay. So looking down, you see a terrible sight. Okay. You see that there are trussed up, guests almost stacked like cordwood below, and they are being violently force fed more cake. Some of them are. Just you see a large wedding cake that looks like the original wedding cake that was maybe for the wedding, and stacks of sugar next to it. And you see that these poor people are being, some of them are being trussed with sugar, and some of them, stuffed with sugar, and some of them are being forced to put their heads over these large barrels that were supposed to have had the family whiskey. And you see these large globular, almost like slime things, like forcing themselves into the mouths of the victims and going, and you see that almost like that victim's being is forcibly consuming them with this weird green runoff coming out of their ears and out of their eyes. And it's like filling them up, and they fall to the side and they're just shaking. And this is just kind of happening. And one of them on the ground who is kind of guiding this whole process, you sort of recognize him as Manuel. Manuel looks exactly like Tim Curry, however. We're going to go with that from Dead Man Walking. So surprise Tim Curry cameo indeed. And I'm going to say, since you know Tim Curry is so cool, I'm going to take away the -2 penalty from earlier and let you see this without being shaken. So you cannot scream, but you do see Tim Curry force feeding cake and slime to a bunch of trussed up people.
They all float down here.
He has a long latex glove. He snaps. Someone's going to get that reference, and it's none of you, and that's fine.
So are you going to come back to the rest of the group?
Yeah, I'm going to go back and say, we got a big problem.
You just announce that when you come out?
No, I'm going to... I'm going to try to whisper it to each member of the group. Say, we got a big problem in the basement. I will talk to Mark first. I will try to get him away from his bride.
Okay, Mark. Yeah. So do you want to, your bride's like, oh, no, stay with me, please, sweetie. Stay with me.
Honey, I need to attend to our guests.
Well, I think you need to you roll a spirit roll to break free for a moment.
All right. I got a 6 on my wild die.
Okay. Roll that again.
And another 1 on top of that, so that's 7.
All right, so you easily break away, and she looks distraught, and she goes over and just sticks a finger in the cake and just eats some of it, and then eats some more cake. So you guys are all, like, in the corner there, I guess, chatting. So chat away.
Oh, man, this is a big
job. I explained to them what I saw, and tell them that Mark has now married into the slime family.
I reach into my pocket where I have like a white lab glove and I slap him across the face and say, "How dare you defame my beautiful bride?"
Really?
Easy there, honey.
No.
So we're trying to. No.
All right, then you go back to your bride. The rest of us will take care of this.
Yeah, we need to go just check it out. You don't know. This has been a weird story. Should probably give it some attention.
Okay. Well, what attention are you giving it?
I'll go down with him to the bathhouse.
So you're going to go back to the drain area?
Is there a way to get downstairs without going down through the grate?
Well, it looks like a pretty large area down there, so much larger than would have gotten those pipes. Like, you couldn't have carried those pipes and
so there should be a door.
If there is, it's not inside here.
All right, I'd like to go outside then and just say I'm going to go get some fresh air.
Okay.
Go outside and see if I can find a door to go down.
Okay, no one stops you outside. So outside, you see that there you're gonna like circle the building. Okay, you do see that there is a storm cellar door attached to the side of the building. It's sort of on the side of the building.
Father Sam will go with him. He's got his case kind of slung over his shoulder now.
Oh, your shotgun. Gotcha. Yeah. Okay.
Anybody else or no? Just us two?
I think I'll go to the grate and maybe see if make sure things don't come out the other side.
Cool. Gracie might be telling doing some toasts or something to try to give you guys some distraction.
I'll tell you what. Go ahead for Gracie. Go ahead and give me a persuasion roll.
Okay.
I thought he was going to make you do a toast.
Me too. I was like, no.
I'm going to make the persuasion.
Dang it. It's also a plus. It's a plus 2. So that is a 9.
All right. So give me give me the toast. What are you saying?
I did not plan for this. Great. That's fine. Thanks a lot, chat. You guys are too slow. To friends, both old and new, to all the sweethearts I've met tonight, to the young ones and old, this is a celebration of two beautiful people getting together. There's nothing nicer in all the
world. That's beautiful!
Yeah, exactly. And maybe I, like, call out some of, like, her... I'm probably just guessing at some of the M names of the Kendrick family. And, you know, you old dog, Maddie, and, you know, like, trying to, like, get them like excited by each other and hopefully laughing. That's all I got.
Okay, all right. Well, they're buying it. So they're all looking at Maddie's there giving that thumbs up. And then you see the rest of your actual party there. There's Delphine, Professor Henry, Bather Skythe, and one orphan left. They've all like sort of huddled together in the corner.
Good. Oh my God.
And you've distracted them quite well.
Okay.
So I'm going to say at the door, so outside the storm door, are one of you fiddling with that door?
Is it locked?
Yes, it is. You can try to lock pick it or break it open.
I will try to unpick it untrained.
All right. What are you using to unpick it?
I have knives.
All right,
lots and lots of knives.
You got a pair of knives. You're gonna unpick. All right, you got a bunch. You get like a bunch of fate chips left.
What the heck, right?
Roll one up.
Oh. Uh, 5.
Okay.
It was a 7 minus 2 is 5.
All right, so that's going to be a success. So you unlock the locking mechanism on there, and you open up the door, and there's this smell of just cake and, you know, sick hitting you. Okay. And grass, and the smell of wet grass.
Okay. All right, we're going to try this.
It's very dark down here. Now, it's not – when you guys looked underneath, there was like a lamp. You do see that there's a lamp at the far end of some corridor. It's a long corridor you'd be walking into, but it's – you don't see like immediately in front of you.
The musical notes of We Are Family get like carried down. You know, I've got the whole room singing together. It's beautiful.
You sure it's not
so time if you want to make some noise, dance. You can. Yeah, exactly.
It's probably time for the chicken dance.
The boa, yeah.
Okay. So the chicken dance is going on.
Yep.
There's nobody.
You're definitely there. Distracted, Craig.
That's all I want to do.
I don't have a problem trying to go through the dark.
Okay. Make a notice roll.
If the father does not. If the father does not.
Make a notice roll with a minus 4 penalty.
Minus 4.
It's totally, you're blind down here. You can't see.
Well, I don't have anything to light my way, so. I don't have a choice. Unless the father's got something.
I rolled a 2.
Okay. Yeah, I rolled about what he rolled. I think I rolled a 3, so.
All right. So you guys actually stumble over someone that was supposed to be watching but didn't. And you see a figure like, what? Huh? And scurrying to its feet, you feel something kind of get violent with you very quickly. and so you both failed. I'm going to say this is going to happen to – who got the lower roll?
That's fine. I'll take it.
All right. So, Craig, something attacks you, okay? And you feel a pair of hands grab your shoulder, okay?
Okay.
Make a fighting roll.
Seven.
Okay. I'm going to spend a fate chip. I'm going to spend another fate chip. 8. 1, 9. All right. So something grabs you, Craig.
Yeah.
and kind of is holding you tight. And pushing past Father Sam, some kind of thing slides along the ground and rises up and just splashes against Craig's face. You see this large, almost ball of darkness. You can't really see it because there's no light except for the moonlight. And it's Craig, you feel something trying to force its way into your mouth and nose.
Okay.
Okay. So you need to make another fighting roll. 7.
15.
All right. So you stop. So you just keep your mouth shut and your eyes shut. And we're going to do a little initiative here. So just write these down since I have the cards on my side. Shady Doug's on an 8 of diamonds. Lopan's on a 4 of diamonds. Gracie Law's on a 6 of clubs. Professor Cornelius Vandersmythe on a 10 of diamonds. Father Sam's on a 9 of diamonds. These cards are definitely shuffled too. And they are on an 8 of spades. We're going to start with 10. Professor Cornelius, what are you doing?
I don't know that there's anything going on, do I?
You don't? You just know there's a party going on.
Chicken dancing it up.
Then I'm doing nothing, I guess.
All your friends left, though, except for Darcy.
Yeah, he's looking distressed. After insulting my wife.
Good call. Okay, so you don't know anything.
This bow is a little bit, prescriptive in terms of playing. So.
Well, I think you beat enough that you can do a little bit here because as long as you're not trying to not get married, you're now married, so you can move around now. You've succeeded in getting married.
Okay. All right. Well, I guess I'm. Is there anybody upstairs besides Darcy, myself, and various Kendricks?
Andy, are you up here or are you outside?
I was watching the grate in the bathhouse.
Okay. So Andy, and what Andy, you're saying is they're distracted even downstairs. They're like dancing with the music that is being played by Kevin Costner and the singing that Darcy's doing while they're force feeding cake to people.
And in case I can hear the fight going on downstairs.
Make a notice check. I hope a player draws two jokers. That's awesome. Sorry, I'm reading the signs.
All right, so Jim, I guess the only thing I'm going to do is I'll turn to Anna and say, Anna, dear, I there are certainly people missing at this point. Where is all of our guests?
Oh, I think they all got tired and so full of cake that they went home.
Gracie pops in.
Is the cake gone?
The cake is, no, it's very eaten.
It's very eaten, okay.
Yes. What is Gracie doing?
She was just going to say, they haven't left. They actually wanted a moment to, you know, say some, they actually have something great surprise planned for the groom here.
That's true. There's a big surprise coming for the groom.
Why don't I take you there, Cornelius?
All right. Well, it's not on your turn, Grace. You can say that, okay, Darcy? Yeah,
cool.
All right. So, what was that, Mark?
Nothing. Nothing.
Which? Why?
The professor's just like. I don't feel like I know enough to do anything.
All right. Well, wait till Darcy's turn for that then. Yeah. Father Sam, what are you doing? There's a big amorphous shape in front of you and a person.
I'm trying to pull the big amorphous shape off of the person.
Okay, cool. Go ahead and roll a fighting roll.
So is that's just a regular fighting roll and then a wild die?
Yes.
Okay. And did they both explode?
Yes.
All right. So you the D4 explodes. Together, I'm sorry?
You just don't add them together.
Don't add them together?
You're going to take the higher of the two dice.
Oh, okay. Gotcha. So 9.
Okay. So you pull this thing off of him, and your hands aren't going into anything squishy. It is a big squishy blob, but your hands like aren't penetrating the squishiness. It's like a big sack. It's like a giant balloon.
All right, so I'm trying to wrestle that thing off of him, and if I can get it pulled loose, I'm going to kind of pull it and fling it to the ground if it comes off.
All right, I'll say you've done that. That's fine.
Then I'm gonna make use of my substantial weight and just start stomping on it.
Well, that'll be next round because your action is kind of tossing it. All right, yeah. So that's Father Sam's turn. It's going to be their turn. It's going to try to push off of you, okay? So could you please make me a strength roll, Father Sam?
Yep.
Fortunately, this is not that strong. Ooh, yeah. Beat a one.
I beat a one.
You pin the blob. Okay. The other one is going to smack. Who was down there with him? It was Lopan. He's gonna smack Lopan. So what is your? There's no way it's gonna hit you out with your die. I rolled a 3. I'm sure that misses.
Yeah.
Okay, that was their turn. No one else notices. Andy, you do see that. And Shady Doug Laveau is your turn. You don't see anyone down there noticing.
I rolled a 5 on my notice roll to hear the fight.
You think you hear the sound of like some thumping at the end of the hallway, and you knew it was happening, so.
Yeah, I'm going to go down and check it out.
So you're going to go outside and around, or you're going to go crawl down into this through like.
I'm going to crawl down the pipe the way that.
Give me another stealth roll.
Alright.
So describe this scene. You're in a long narrow chamber with a bunch of barrels against the wall, these big casks, and there's just a trussed up bodies. Right now it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There are right now 12 bodies stacked up, all trussed up, and most of them are just like sort of shaking as they have been force fed. Both first cake and then other stuff.
9 stealth.
Okay. They do not see you or hear you.
Okay. Can I look around to see if I can figure out where the
There are three of these things down there. There are three, like not things. There are three members of the Kendrick family down there. One of them being Tim Curry, but named Manuel. Manuel Tim Curry is his full name.
So they're not fighting with Lopan. And-
No. They're in the center hallway. They're not at the far end.
Fight was down the drain.
Now the fight's at the other side of this. They're outside, went into a side entrance. The fight's in a side entrance somewhere. You're separate from them. So if the fighting is here, you're here.
Can I make my way to them, to that?
Sure. Yeah. But that's that's your whole action, though.
That's fine.
All right. Gracie, what are you saying?
I'm trying to make the lovely, blushing bride let me get Cornelius away from her for a bit to go see the surprise that we on the groom's side planned for him.
Oh, nice. Okay, well, give me a persuasion roll.
Okay.
I don't know. I do want to spend time with my sweetie.
Sweetie. I'm going to spend a Benny.
Okay.
I'm sure.
Which color are you going with?
Another white.
Okay.
I'll be back in
a much better in eight.
Okay, so she's okay with that. Okay, we'll bring him back soon.
Oh, of course, honey.
Wait, here, give him this. And she gives you a muffin to give to him.
Okay.
He's not sweet enough yet. Not yet.
Where were you hiding that?
You'll find out later.
All right, I'm going to take him outside. Okay. That's where I think people have... going.
Lopan, it's your turn.
All right, so there is the father has the big squishy thing pinned, right?
Yes.
There was another thing that grabbed me.
There's a man down there, it feels like. It feels like a man down there.
Okay, I am going to attack the man.
Okay.
Because of my kung fu training, I get two attacks.
Yep. Everyone's
that's seven.
It's a hit.
And then the other one is five.
Now you hit twice.
Okay.
Damage two times. Toughness is six.
Okay, so that's six. And that's eight.
Okay. A six is going to... All right, so you hit him. So the six takes him to being shaken, and the eight takes him out completely.
Oh, wow.
And he gets to make a spirit roll.
Nice.
So which he makes. So what you see happen is he collapses and just forcibly ejects out of his mouth and nose this large blob of something that splashes along the ground outside and slithers away.
Okay.
And as the face, you see it in the moonlight. The face is the face of the baker.
Is he alive now? Is he still alive?
No, he's dead.
He's dead? Okay.
So that was the end of that round. There was still the blob there. So Shady Doug Laveau's in a seven of hearts. Lopan's a three of clubs. Gracie Law is a two of hearts. Professor Cornelius Vandersmythe is a seven of spades. Father Sam's a five of diamonds, and they are on a four of clubs. So we're going to start with Professor Cornelius Vandersmythe.
Again?
You're outside. Yeah.
Why do I never get initiative when I actually want to do
this? I know. Well, you're outside. Yeah, exactly. And being outside, Mark, you just saw, as Gracie brought Cornelius out there, you saw the baker collapse and barf up a giant blob the size of a beanbag chair.
Well, that ain't right. Betsy, that ain't right. And
at witnessing that, it actually will break your vow.
Okay. Oh, man.
All right. So something is afoot. What? I said, what in the hell is going on here? And I pull Betsy off of my back, and I turn to this big crank on the side, and it like this cylinder inside starts to spark to life, and I let loose a barrage of lightning at this blob.
Okay.
I am spending 2 power points to do a 3d6 blast, or bolt, rather.
Okay.
And let's see if I can hit it. Considering the way my dice have been rolling this evening?
Probably not.
Oh, for crying out loud. All right, I am spending my last chip, my red chip, to add a d6. Oh, there we go. That's a 6.
Nice.
I get a 6.
A 3. So that's a total of 12 to hit.
That definitely hits with a raise. Add an extra 6 cider in damage.
Crap, need a 6 cider. I don't have enough 6 siders.
This is the blob.
There we go.
I'm going to try so having
4d6 damage.
Holy crap.
Like I said before,
you're muted if you're talking.
Is this
like
Shadowrun?
It was don't give me a lightning gun and expect me not to use it.
Yeah, we have stepped into Shadowrun here.
Holy Moses. That is 20 damage.
I'm not even going to
try. Wait, did damage dice explode?
Yes.
Oh, God.
So 20... 21. All right.
There goes the saloon behind the beanbag.
Yeah.
There's Cornelius's hole now in the middle of this town.
Yeah.
That's the name of the town
that's
now.
That's what they're going to name this big crater in the middle of the town.
I'm going to say with that much damage, you kill it and you zap the one next to it, and they both, like, just pop. And you feel this large release of spray all over I'm going to sell off a low pan, and then Shady Doug just showed up and got hit with it too.
Then slimed.
Big green pop. Cool. And out of the front door, you hear, "Sweetie! Sweetie, what? What? What did you do? What did you do, sweetie?"
And I got my lightning gun, and I look, turn to my wife, and she doesn't look at any different, right?
Her right eye is bulging a bit, like, rhythmically.
What do you mean, like, bulging rhythmically?
Like, it's starting to come out and come back in a little bit.
Oh, that ain't right.
It's going to be Shady Doug Laveau's turn.
Wow. All right.
So, how many things do I see here? The whole family's here, down here?
Well, no, downstairs are only 3 people. It's 2 of the M-name ones. We're going to say it's Morty and Mitch, and then Manuel Tim Curry.
Manuel Tim Curry Kendrick.
Because it's 10:15, and people wanted to see the mechanics of the
yes, the everyone's yet. Go
I'm
for
going
it.
Huckster. And I actually failed because I only got ace high, and that's only give you 1 power point.
All right, so 1 power point doesn't get you there.
Not for both, no, it means 2.
I'd be happy to donate a fate point.
You have any fate chips, Andy?
Oh, yeah. How does that work with the cards?
Just, you're drawing cards. You're trying to be cheap there. All right, I think when you fail on that, it's a backfire. So I'm going to roll a d20 backfire on your spell. Or you want to roll a d20, Andy.
All right.
Hucks your backfire table. Yeah, Mr. Andy Katie, Mr. Costner is still playing the music, and only the one eye can hear it. So actually, you guys all see that he's playing like My Wild Irish Rose right now, and the left eye is bulging in and out like conducting the song.
My wild Irish rose, ding, 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 ding. The sweetest flower that grows, ding, ding, ding.
Yeah, that's happening.
This is why priests take the vow of celibacy.
Agreed.
To just 16. Avoid all of this.
Andy, corruption. Hex is twisted. So the damage causing effect affects your allies. So it's going to affect you and who's next to you. There are no allies next to you, but there is. So go ahead and cause the damage, and it's going to affect you and Lopan. I'm sorry. This is allies. It just hurts Lopan. and Father Sam.
Okay, so bolt is 2d6 for 1 bolt. Is that correct?
Yep.
Okay.
Roll one out, homie.
6.
All right. Is a 6 beat your toughness, either Craig or Will?
I have a 6.
You're shaking.
I have a 5.
You're shaking. You're both shaking.
Is this a visible bolt?
Yes.
All right.
What kind of bolt is it, Andy?
It's a playing card.
The flying eagle? Oh, it's a okay. So you
wrong game.
Charge up. It's like a ethereal playing card. It kind of just
ethereal playing card hits you both.
It's a yeah. Well, at least you. That's
5 of diamonds. That's you, Will. You're shaken. So let's try to roll to not be shaken. So why don't you give me a spirit roll?
Spirit roll. Seven.
All right, you are successful. Go ahead and do something.
All right, so I got attacked by some blob thing in the dark. I get attacked from something outside of the tunnel.
Yeah,
this
playing
is
card.
Freaking me out.
Yeah.
I'm just going to pick up the Wrath of God, which is my Gatling chain gun, shotgun thing, and just start spraying out of the tunnel.
All right, outside. So you're spraying outside into the air?
Outside, yeah. That's where the thing came in and hit me.
No, the card came from inside, didn't it?
The card came from inside.
Oh, yeah. I'm sorry. Then back down the tunnel, especially since that's dark and I couldn't.
Make 2 rolls, -4 each against Andy.
All
right.
Attack
the darkness.
Attack the darkness. Magic missile.
Yeah.
Where do my guns go?
So you're going to attack Andy, essentially.
Is that regular? Oh, it's shooting. Okay.
Yeah, that's awesome. This is the best.
All right, so I got a 6 on one of them, and I got a 10 on the other.
Well, the 10 is a 6. So a 6 is going to hit. Now, the 6, is that with a -4 penalty?
Oh, no, with the -4.
You hit once. Gonna... So okay. Andy takes 3d6 points of damage.
Okay.
Ouch.
You guys have successfully shot the hell out of each other better than you shot these things. Actually, no. Cornelius Vandersmythe pulled this off so far.
Okay, so 3d6 is going to be 12 points of damage.
All right, Andy. What's your toughness?
Your toughness is 5.
So you're going to be hit with 1 wound. So you can go ahead and soak if you want. So you can make a spend a fate chip to roll a vigor check.
All right, I'll do that.
And I'll nudge Lopan in the arm and say, "I got one of the bastards."
That's so good. Right.
11.
Fear of God in them.
Andy, you've taken no damage, Andy. You are hit. You are peppered, Andy, but you like drop to the ground and it all just affects your coat. You know, and you're getting shot up and you hear like someone screaming to Jesus and shooting a shotgun down the one into the hallway.
It's like a wedding.
You know? Yeah, it's like any wedding. All right. It's their turn. So with the shotgunning sound, Manuel, Tim Curry, Morty, and Mitch are going to come investigate. And they start coming down the hallway, but they can't see very well either. So they're bringing one of the torches with them. So they're going down the hall. They make it the whole way there, but they don't do anything yet. And then the spouse, you see the angriness of Anna Kendrick as bulging eye is just looking at you. Angrily, Professor Cornelius, and she says, "You better stop them. You made a vow. You promised." A shotgun wedding, according to Andrew Cady.
Oh, boy. That was what you having.
It's an electrostatically charged phlogistonic beam cannon wedding, thank you very much.
She actually bolts, when you say that, she bolts back inside and starts shouting commands.
Oh, boy.
In some weird language you can't understand, but it sounds like burping. That's her action.
Yeah, I hate to tell it to you, but I think we may need to get a divorce.
You know what? That's a good one. I'm giving you – you can take a white fate chip for that. Lopan, it's your turn.
All right, so 3 guys are coming down the hallway at me with a light, right?
Yes.
Okay. I'm going to activate my deflection first.
Okay.
And then
I'm
going.
Looks like this, right?
What?
Looks like this.
Yeah.
We do it, right?
Yeah. There you go.
We're jazz hands.
Jazz hands. And then I'm going to. You said they got all the way towards me.
No, they're getting all the way to you. Not to you yet.
Can I activate my deflection and attack?
That'd be 2 actions. It'd be a -2 penalty to each.
That's fine. I'll wait.
Okay. All right. You're staying down there, though.
Yeah, I'm going to stay right there.
Okay.
I'm trying to hide in the darkness.
Gracie Law, what are you doing?
So currently the bride just went in.
Yes, and she's shouting commands that sounds like burping.
All right, yeah, I would like to chase after her and take a couple shots at her with my Gatling pistol.
All right, make two shots.
As I pass Cornelius, I'm like, sorry, bud. It's got to be done.
That man is my wife.
If anybody's going to shoot her, I am.
Damn straight.
He hasn't even raced a horse to the railroad crossing with her yet.
Yes. Good callback.
You know what? Father Sam gets a white face. He definitely gets a white face ship for that.
Awesome.
All right, take two shots, Darcy.
All right. Roll number one. So that's a.
Case, I had to put your gotta put your wife down.
Yeah. Oh, that's the six explodes.
It does.
So that's a nine.
No, it's a hit with a raise. So cause damage with an extra six sider.
Okay. That's 2d6 plus 2 plus an extra 6 cider. That's
9, right?
5, 6, 7, 8, 9, yeah.
9, all right, and her toughness is 6. So it's going to be, she's going to be, I'm going to actually spend to have her soak, which I don't do. I'm spending again. All right, she's shaking. Two chips, nothing. Two ones, yeah.
That was my first shot, right?
Oh, crap. Okay, yeah.
Yes.
Right. The first shot hits her square in the neck. She grabs it. So it's a graze, yes. Though. It's a graze. That's okay. Your whole second time.
So this draft is...
A four
this
hit.
This I only... Okay, it does. Cool. Yes. So do damage.
2d6 plus one.
So that's... Yeah, that's seven.
She takes wounds. All right, she is still up.
Okay. All right, and I'm going to try to, like, duck back around the corner of the doorway that I shot through.
All right. She hear her, and inside you hear a whole crew of, like, 13 other voices saying, and you see on this turn, you see that Professor Henry Bathurst-Skyth just runs out of the building, and Delphine and dragging one cake-smeared orphan run out as well. So they all run outside. Nice. On two, it's that was your turn. So top of the order, Shady Doug's on a two of spades, Lopan's on a jack of diamonds, Gracie Law's on a seven of diamonds, Professor Cornelius Vandersmythe's on a king of hearts, Father Sam's on a seven of clubs, and a jack of spades for the baddies. So guess what? Professor Cornelius Vandersmythe goes first on his wedding day
on
again.
His king of hearts on his wedding day. This is amazing.
All right. I am going to go chasing after my wife and Gracie.
Okay.
And I the blast power says that I can fire, or bolt power rather, says that I can fire three bolts by spending as many points.
Yes.
Can I shoot those at the same person, or is that only for multiple targets? Shoot
all three at once. If you want a machine gunner down with lightning, that's fine.
You know what? I'm going to just do a 3d6 bolt like my last one.
A super big bolt.
A super big bolt like my last one. That seems like it's probably the more likely way to succeed in actually hitting.
Sure. Sure. Go for it.
So, let's see. Five with my D8 and a five with my wild die. So, yep. All right, I guess I got a five.
Yep, so roll damage.
And 3d6. Eleven.
Okay, that's going to hit her. That's going to be... All right, she is barely standing up anymore. She's kind of... Why?
No wife of mine is going to be belching like that in public.
Propriety.
You hear the chorus inside of that burping, and the chorus is going to go. They grab her from inside, and they kind of pull her in, and three more come to the front of the door. And, you know, they're in their flesh, but they three of them just throw kitchen utensils at you, Mark.
I'll dodge, I guess. Yeah.
You're hit twice, once with a raise.
All right. I can't, all right, so like the one defenses in this game, right? I just take it.
Yeah, so you're going to roll. Well, so one does, what's your toughness?
5.
All right, so you take 7 and 5 damage. So you're hit. So you're the one, you're going to be shaken and you're taking a wound. So here's the deal. You can, for it's 2 separate hits. On the wound, if you want to spend your last fate chip to try to soak that, you can.
What does that entail?
Just roll a vigor check. You want to eat the wound?
How many wounds can I take?
You can take, on your 4th one, you go down.
And there's no penalty or anything when you have
you're
a wound.
You're -1 to all actions while you have a wound.
I'm going to take this one.
All right, so you're hit with a very heavy ladle, and you're hit with a fork, and there's a fork sticking out of your arm. Then downstairs, Manuel, Tim Curry, Morty, and Mitch all descend upon Lopan. So here comes those attacks.
Okay.
So you are attacked 3 times, Craig?
Yes.
All right, and you are, what is your fighting?
It's a D8, but they're also -2 to each roll.
So I'm sorry, what was your parry?
Parry's a 6.
All right, so -2 to each roll. All right, you are like totally fending off, and they're all fighting with clubs. And you're like, you're totally Jackie Channing down here. It is awesome. It is totally Shanghai Noon. You defend all 3 attacks. None of them hit you. I'm going to have on one of them, I'm going to spend a Benny. No.
Nice.
I can't do crap tonight. All right.
Take his bennies. Good.
All right.
You got to give us more bennies so that we can give you bennies back.
Yeah, no, seriously. Jack is Lopan. Lopan's on you.
All right. I'm going to punch 2 of them. Ooh, that's an 8. 12.
That's a hit with a raise. An extra 6 iron damage.
Wow, yeah.
All right, so
just the fury.
Fifteen.
One's down.
What the heck?
Okay, so
Mitch is down. Mitch is down.
Mitch is down. All right, so.
And Mitch does not eject himself from the court either.
Ooh. 7. 7 to hit.
That's going to be a shaken.
All
right. Oh, I'm sorry. That guy's hits. I'm sorry.
That was the hit, so that's not damage. So.
Yeah. Keeps rolling dice.
17. Over and over. The 4-sider keeps landing on the 4, so 17 total.
That one also goes down and does not eject itself. You're left with Manuel Tim Curry.
Okay. That's it. I'm out.
All right. Lopan's done. 7 of diamonds is Gracie Law. So they are now flinging utensils from the inside of the building.
Yeah. I mean, I think I'm going to take some, take some pot shots at so is the wife still up? Or she kind of went.
They dragged her inside.
They dragged her inside.
There are a total of 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 9, 10, 12. There are 12 inside plus her.
That's too many.
That's a lot.
They're a lot, yeah.
Well, until I get a better idea, I'm going to take some Gatling gun pot shots.
All right, so we're going to have cover, so it's -2 to each shot.
Okay.
And you're trying to beat a 4.
Okay. So that one does not hit. So the first one doesn't hit. Second one does.
-2.
Nope, doesn't hit. Nope. Well, let me spend a Benny and add some to that then.
All right, you're spending a red or a blue?
I'm spending a blue.
Ha. All right, so add a 6-sider to that 5.
Cool. Okay, so that's a 9.
All right, that's a hit with a, -2. It's a 7.
An 8, or sorry, yeah.
You hit. All right, roll damage. 2d6 plus 1 for the Gatling pistol.
Yay. So that's 7.
All right, that's going to shake one of them.
Perfect. I'll take it for now.
Cool. All right. Gracie went. Father Sam.
So the Manuel Tim Curry is fighting Lopan. Yes. Am I going to be able to shoot at that without hitting him?
You could certainly shoot at him and potentially hit him.
All right. Sounds good.
So if you miss, you may hit an adjacent target. So it could be fun.
Cool. All right. 5 and a 3.
All right.
So the 5?
5's going to hit.
Okay.
And he has light.
3d6 damage. Oh, my gosh. 18.
You roll 3 sixes?
I did.
They all explode. Roll them again.
They all explode. All right. One of those exploded again and again. I've lost count. 3, 4, 5, 6. 36, 41, 44.
All of the damage.
Are we playing Gods of the Fall? Like, I feel like we got one Gods of the Fall character.
Gods of the West.
All right. Yeah. Craig, make a guts roll.
I got
-5. -3 penalty.
Well, then it's a 2.
All right. So roll a d20, Craig.
Uh-oh.
10.
All right, Craig, you are panicked.
Okay.
This is what happens, okay? There is a massive explosion as Manuel Tim Curry just evaporates in the middle of the air. He explodes, and then the ooziness bursts out of his head like a mushroom cloud of green chlorophyll-y stuff, and then that pops with a greenish glowing blow. And then while that's happening, all the shards are like exploding around you of this green slop. Each one is being shot by Father Sam, like skeet shooting all of them, screaming out hymns and homilies and stuff as he's doing it. And this is the most frightening thing you've ever seen in North America. And you are panicked, run at your full pace plus a running die away from the danger, and you're shaken. Okay. You already watched 9. Father Sam shoot Shady Doug Laveau. All
right, so 6 plus 3 is 9, so I run 9 away.
Shady Doug Laveau, it's your turn. You just watched this happen.
I don't have any ill effects from that.
No, you were able. You were okay with it.
Okay.
There you go. Viper 52 says, "Well, looks like the buffet is all out of curry."
Oh,
that's awesome.
I don't like it, but I have to respect it.
Point for enduring that pun.
Yeah. Who gets it? You know what? Yeah, everyone gets a fate chip for that one right there.
Thank you.
All right. So Shady Doug gets a white. Lopan gets a white. Gracie Law gets a red. Cornelius gets a white. Father Sam gets a white. That was good. I'm going to shake it up a little bit.
Thank you, Pit Viper.
Yeah, thank you.
So anyway, Andy, what are you doing?
Does fate want me to still demonstrate the powers of the huckster, or just blast something? Because
Huckster powers didn't work too well for you last week. You have points to spend.
Yeah, I'm just going to spend them.
But what are you going to spend it on? There's no more baddies downstairs.
Oh.
You can pop up back from the sewer inside and do something if you want to the 13 the 13 that are inside.
Yeah, I'm going to go back and – well, the blog ran away, right?
Yeah, so what you see down there, Andy, so you know, is you down there mm-hmm. see all the trussed bodies. And you see these like oozing casks that are full of just things. They're trying to get out, but they can't get enough of their weight. Like, they can't get out correctly.
All right.
Wrapped.
Can I try to help them?
One of the oozes? You want to help one of the oozing casks?
Well, those like the guests of the...
The guests are on the ground just shaking, and their bodies are full of that liquid.
And they're not
full of the slime, or are they full of the
full of slime and cake?
Are they hooked up to anything?
They're just convulsing.
All right, well, I'm gonna leave them go then. Leave that to the father. I can't do anything about it.
Okay, that's fine. It's funny. It's like, leave them.
I could help. I could, but you know. I'm a huckster, I'm a doctor. So I'm gonna...
Dang it, Jim.
yep. So I'm gonna chase after the bride. It ran away.
All right, so you're gonna pop. So where are you going, back outside, or are you gonna go back up through the sewer?
Where did she go?
You didn't even see her. You haven't seen her at all because you're inside the basement.
That's confused about where everything
is. Come back outside if you meet with everybody else up. You want?
Yeah, I'm gonna do that.
Gracie's yelling for backup.
New round.
Yeah, sure.
Andy's on a 5 of hearts. Lopan's on a 10 of clubs. Gracie's on a 9 of hearts. Professor Cornelius Vandersmythe on a 2 of clubs. Father Sam gets the Joker and a 3 of hearts for the baddies. So on a Joker, you can do anything you want, Father Sam. It's a +2 to anything you do, including damage.
Oh, snap. All right.
What do you want to do?
Oh, and I go first? Okay, so if I could see Shady Doug enough to take a shot at him, or I guess I couldn't see him, I got hit by him.
Yes.
So do I like know enough? Can I see enough down the hallway to know that there are no more bad guys down there?
Yeah, so there's a light source now because they had that torch they brought down at the end of the hallway. That's how you could see later, you know.
Okay.
So yeah, you can see the hallway down. You see what I described. You see about 15 barrels. Some of them are full of this pulsing liquid inside of them, and you see about, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, about 12 bodies trussed up and stacked like cordwood.
Okay.
Convulsing.
Yeah, no, we'll come back and help them. So I'm gonna follow Lopan because he was clearly running off to face whatever new threat is outside.
Sure.
So I'm gonna run off outside and see what I see out there.
That's exactly what I was doing.
Yep.
Okay, that's your Joker then. All right, yep. Good deal. I like that usage of a Joker. All right, 10 of clubs. That's going to be Lopan.
All right.
You are shaken. Make a spirit check.
Okay. That's a 5.
All right, you are unshaken. What do you want to do?
Come back.
All right, you return. So Father Sam walked up to you, and you walk away from Father Sam. You're back with Gracie.
Back outside, like Gracie and him are all outside, so I'm back because I had to run away, so I came back.
I figured you ran outside though, so.
Oh, okay. Well, then I'm getting ready to go in the building with everybody else.
All right, you're back with everyone. Gracie, your turn.
Yeah, I think she's just gonna. So there's everybody's behind cover, right?
Yeah, they're all out of view now.
Okay, and then I'm gonna start stalking into the room and try to find like a good piece of cover myself and try to get like a doorway.
So you're gonna run into the room?
I think so. I'm gonna like quick step around the corner and make sure no one's like hiding around the corner for me. But okay. She's gonna use her lawman skills.
Okay, so you find a place to like cover and get down inside. Shady Doug. So Gracie just went in the front entrance. You're downstairs still. Oh no, you came upstairs, didn't you?
I came up, yeah.
Right. So Gracie went inside.
I'm gonna follow her.
All right. So you're in there too. You see. You actually don't see. You see, they're all retreating backwards into the bathhouse, like into the bath chambers.
Okay. Can I follow them?
Sure. So you—that's your like a whole round to do both, and you see that they all are now like bending over like the drains in the women's area, and they're trying to throw up into the sinks.
Okay.
Oh no. They're gonna escape.
All right, Professor Cornelius Van. Oh, their turn. All right, so they're gonna start. They're gonna start doing this. All right, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All right, 6 of them successfully project themselves down the drains.
No.
And there's another 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There's 6 plus your wife that's still there. So now the wife is, she's trying to do it too. She failed. All right, that's their action. 2.
My turn.
Yep.
At long last.
At long last.
Love has arrived.
All right, so I'm gonna. Gracie and Shady went inside, right?
Yes.
All right, so I'm gonna follow them, and I see all of these various Kendricks barfing into the sinks.
Yes.
In the bathhouse, right?
Yes.
And the pipes are made out of metal?
Correct.
Oh, wow.
Oh, no!
That's right!
Oh, oh, that's right! Oh,
yes!
All right. Now I am doing a triple shot.
Oh, my gosh.
Use all my bennies. Let's use all that's the bennies.
Awesome.
I've got a bunch to loan as well.
To do three lightning bolts. I'm going to target my wife with one.
Okay.
I'm going to target the sinks and the pipes with the other two.
Okay.
And I'm going to say to my gun, I'm going to say, Betsy dear, it's time to kick the third wheel to the curb. Right.
Ain't love beautiful?
Oh my god, that is utterly awful. That is a two, a two, a one, and a one. So I'm spending a white chip.
Okay.
Because that is embarrassing.
That is bad.
That is a lot better. I got a four, but that's a minus. That's got a minus one on it. So all right, hold on. So seven hits, an eight gets a reroll, which makes that a 10, which is a 9.
Okay. The raise, that one.
And can I, if I spend a Benny to reroll, can I choose to only reroll some of the dice?
I don't care. Whatever. That's fine.
All right. I'm spending the other light chip to reroll the two dice.
Sorry, viewers. This is a good scene.
Didn't do anything useful. And there we go. Another eight, which rolls another eight. Which rolls a four, so that's a 20, which is a 19.
That's still only at one extra die of damage. So the two, those are two, there's extra d6 in damage for both of those.
All right, so the shot at Anna.
I think it should be a musical, Jason. I think so for sure. I think that we should have more singing in games.
all right, let's see here. So the shot at Anna is going to do 3d6 damage, and we've got a 2 and a 4 and a 6.
And he's shooting with his lightning gun.
So a total of 17 damage to Anna.
Last chip I got to soak with.
And then
3-1.
Should I roll? Can I just roll the two other shots as a combined total damage? Do you want me to roll them separate?
Separate. She's separate. Dead. All
right.
You zapped her. She's toast. All
right.
You have to sing this, though, according to Jason.
What?
Sing your dice results.
This is what you do, Jason.
Zap, 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 zap.
I got a seven.
He got a seven in his roll.
He's going to seven.
He's coming to seven.
Hold on. Still rolling. A 26.
There is 26 damage to everything in the pipes. They all die. All
right, so you, everything in the pipes is electrocuted.
Yay.
And horribly killed. I would say that anything touching them would be the same way. That's pretty much all of them take that much damage. So that's toasty.
So yeah, so Cornelius, like, he's like, he overcharged his gun, and it's just like Ghostbusters, just like a constant stream of lightning that comes out. He rakes it across his wife, rakes it down onto the sinks, and it just starts like, you know, coruscating over the pipes and down in the pipes, and there's like these pops and bubbles of goo jumping out of the thing, and then it, finally, like, it runs dry, and it's just like, he says, "Ah, divorces are far more satisfying than I had heard."
So with them dead, what do you want to do?
You gotta kill the ones in the basement.
It is the ones downstairs that are in the buckets, in the barrels.
There's more?
Well, they can't get out of the barrels. Yeah, there's more of those liquidy things in the barrels downstairs.
Use them for your experiments.
You can keep them.
Absolutely.
Okay. How about the bodies that are trussed up?
Well, for giant slimy things.
How about the trussed up bodies?
Are they dead or are they alive?
They're alive.
Are they being assimilated?
Are they?
Could I roll knowledge occult to figure out a way to like make them less?
Can't we just horrific? Stick fingers down their throats and get them to upchuck the bad guys?
You can try if you want.
Yeah, now that I've seen what we're up against, I'm going to try to do a mad science roll to see
is Father Sam going to try to make them throw up with the finger down the throat?
Not my finger, no. I'm going to find something that
somebody else's finger.
Something I won't miss if it gets bit off.
Like what?
Like a ladle. Like a fork end from upstairs, not the pointy end, the handle.
When you stick the fork in its mouth, there's like a slight sizzle to the fork, as if the fork is burning. Whatever's in them is corrosive.
Diagnose a way to maybe treat these poor people.
Put some baking soda on it.
Yeah, no.
That's regular science. That's not weird science.
Whatever's in them is whatever's in their mouth corroded a fork.
That would be bad.
Can I assist Chrissy in her occult role?
Yes, yes, you may actually.
Yeah, I have knowledge occult too. I'll assist there too.
Okay, I only have a D6, so someone else is free to take it.
I mean, I only have a D6 too. So
how does helping work?
My occult is D6.
Okay, so pick somebody to roll.
All the same.
I'm rolling.
Good, Darcy.
I'm rolling 2D6, and I don't know how help works. Is it a
we're gonna roll 2D6, add 4 to one of them. So we're gonna say 8. All right.
Nice. Thank you.
You are pretty sure they are all being digested on the inside.
Gastric juices, great. Basically we want to neutralize the acid, right? There's a kitchen. No, there isn't. There are forks, but that was just from the baked goods, right?
True.
This is Darcy talking instead of Gracie.
It's okay.
I'm going to stop.
Well, we need to get them to throw up, so is there anything that we would know in
Heimlich?
That time frame that would cause them to barf if ingested?
I mean, there's always,
like a lot of whiskey? Start pouring whiskey down there, because even if it doesn't make them barf, it might mess up the... Plus, drunk kids are just funny. Drunken orphans.
So funny.
All right, so you're going to start shoving whiskey down their throats?
Yeah, real whiskey, not the barrels from...
All right, go ahead and give me a healing check.
Jim Ryan suggested castor oil. That's correct.
I did say that, yeah.
Whiskey first.
Whiskey first. That's pretty much my motto. 4 on the healing check.
Okay, so are you trained in it?
Yeah.
Oh, cool. Okay. All right, so you successfully get the bottle in that one's mouth, and you pour alcohol, and it's just it you don't know if it's going to work, and all of a sudden – you feel a large, it just gives way, and it's Patricia, the wife of Professor Henry Bathurstyth, and she throws up something that resembles a large green beanbag chair.
Oh my god.
I'll zap it.
Yeah.
All right, so I'm going to say it's not hard to zap it. She just rolls over and it's like, oh dear, that was terrible.
Yay.
What happened to her husband?
He's outside. So repeating the process one by one, you can't save everyone, but you do save a few of them.
Nice.
And including all 6 orphans. Aww. Or 5 orphans that were down there. And that's probably the best wedding present that Professor Cornelius Vandersmythe could have. And that's probably a good place to end. I have nothing else after that. So unless any of you wants to add anything at the very end of this.
I want to know what he does with the barrels of goop.
I did say in my wedding vows that it would be one of my mad science devices that would tear us apart.
What are you doing with the goop, Mark?
We'll have to find out in a future play.
Next episode.
Oh, nice.
There you go.
All right, well, we're going to wrap this up. First, I want to thank all of you guys for being awesome players today and joining us today. It was great. And
thank you.
Thank you.
I want to thank everyone who especially stuck to the end here, you know. Yeah. So Pit Viper 52 and Jim Ryan, Jason Levine, and oh, crap, there's many people on here that were, and Janana Sajay was on here, and earlier we had Dead Man Walkin', and yeah, just Andrew Cady. Awesome. Priyanko Paul was on there. That's a good name. All right, so yeah, everyone, really appreciate all coming in and adding some tidbits to the game. It was made it a lot of fun. So I hope everyone had a good time. Again, just a reminder, just a couple pieces of if you enjoyed the game, make sure you like, comment, and subscribe below. That always helps out. The other thing is, if you enjoyed the game and you think Deadlands is the game for you, it's a Western and there was vomiting slime creatures. You can check out the Kickstarters. The links are below. You can definitely go to it's PEGINC, PEGINC.com to check out the game itself if you want to go order one of the books for to try Deadlands Reloaded, which is a Savage Worlds game. And the last thing I'll say is I will have this adventure as it is written. So it'll be written as with all of this crazy stuff, including the, you know, the character names and everything. I'm going to have this posted on my blog in the next day or so. So you can play against Anna Kendrick and her evil family with your players if you want. And that should be a lot of crazy fun, hopefully. So
that's that was it. Awesome.
All right. So thanks, everyone. And hope you all have a good night.
Nice gaming with you. Bye.
Good night, everybody.